Hi, I'm Sarah Maiga, buyer's agent and team leader of the Maiga Homes Real Estate Team. In my previous YouTube series, Buying and Selling at the Same Time, I covered the topic, what is a contingent on sale offer? Well, today we're going to cover the term contingency in general as it pertains to real estate. So, what does contingent mean? Well, it can mean two things. The first, it can mean that the home has accepted an offer and has a signed purchase agreement. An accepted offer is almost always considered contingent until closing, whether it is a mortgage or cash sale, as it is not an official sale until funds are exchanged and the transaction closes. Furthermore, depending on the MLS that the agent who listed the property subscribes to, there may be different categories depending on their realtor board requirements as to how to designate or mark a property that has accepted an offer, which will, believe it or not, display on various real estate sites differently. For more information on that topic, I will cover the intricacies of the MLSs in a future episode. The second meaning of contingency is that an offer on a new home has been made and the seller has accepted it, but that the final sale is contingent upon certain criteria that need to be met. The most common home sale contingencies that are written into a purchase agreement are homeowners association bylaw and master deed review, home inspection, lawyer review, flood insurance, appraisal, survey, financing, title, and a home sale. Now, these are not always exercised by the purchaser, but these clauses will be put into a contract and negotiated between the parties up front. As you can see, the reason a home is considered contingent until funds are exchanged and the deed is signed is because there are a lot of opportunities for a contingency to not be met. For instance, if the buyer is dissatisfied with the home inspection or their due diligence period, which can involve bylaw master deed review or a lawyer's opinion, the buyer can walk away and get their earnest back during this time frame. If the home doesn't appraise to what the buyer offered the seller, either party reserves the right to walk away from the transaction. Now, this is true for all the other contingencies as well, so it's important to know what your contingencies are and the deadline for each. Once the time for each contingency has passed, you may no longer use that as a reason to stop the purchase. Should you not want to proceed, you would need another failed contingency if they still remain, or the seller would be entitled to keep your earnest money deposit as damages for breach of contract. Now, I'm not going to get into the intricacies of earnest money deposits and breach of contract in this episode, but stay tuned as I will cover it in a future episode. As you can see, there is a lot to understanding purchase agreement, contingencies, but with an experienced realtor on your side, you'll have the right preparation and guidance to know exactly which contingencies are right for you. If you have any remaining questions about this topic or anything else involving real estate, reach out to me today at the number below. I would be happy to help and be a resource for you. In addition, I create custom moving plans for each of my clients up to a year in advance so that we can be fully prepared and partners in this journey. So if you think you're within a year of making a move, reach out to me today and set up a consultation. Plus, if I'm not able to personally assist you, I'm part of a global real estate company and can refer you to a similarly qualified agent anywhere in the world. Be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel today and tune in weekly to learn more about the home buying process. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.